everybody. Forgot to grab the game, so hold on. Alrighty. Go ahead and get this. And there I am. Hi. Welcome in, everybody. And let's change this out because we're not playing Cupid War tonight. Oh. We're playing something even better. Alrighty, I think I've got everything. Now I've got everything. So yeah, hey everybody, we're playing Eternal Darkness, which y'all can't see. There it goes. Very excited.
Deep into that darkness peering, long I stood there, wondering, fearing, doubting.
My absolute favorite scary game of all time. And I mean, it's older now, so it's not as up to date on the graphics, but
Nintendo.
Still one of the best scary games ever created, and I will fight you on that.
You too will come to understand fear as I have.
Silicon Knights. We're working on a sequel for this, and just didn't happen. I'm more upset about that than Silent Hills. But only by a little bit. Yes, it is! Goddamn right it is. The best fucking scary game of all time. And I haven't played this in years. Yes, this is my absolute favorite scary game. A very close second is Layers of Fear. Like this just, I think if I hadn't played this as a kid, I wouldn't be able to appreciate Lovecraft or any horror at all. And I said horror. Really? I finished it multiple times. I got one of the main three deities, and also got the secret fourth deity too. Which, I don't know, we may or may not go that far. Oh man, it's some happiness right here. Okay, whoa, that's... Okay, subtitles on. Okay, just gotta make sure everything is, yeah. I'm curious how far this one is. Kareem. Okay, so this one I've already played. Keep getting close. You gotta play this, you're gonna watch me play it through. I really want to come back and play that one, but we're gonna start a new one.
Flesh, bone, bound together with the oddest magical incantation. This wretched book is where it all began so long ago. before time, before humanity. I am Dr. Edward Roivas. I am a clinical psychologist. I am also dead.
This is not my
story, nor even the story of the Roivas family. It is the story of humanity. Like it or not, believe it or not, as you will. Your perceptions will not change reality, but simply color it. Humanity has been on the edge of extinction for 2 millennia.
Because I've got it turned all the way up in my ears.
Ignorant of so much, and dependent on so few. The Guardians grow restless.
I want to bury myself in
their time once again near.
Okay, it's good.
Whether by fate or misfortune, my family has crossed their path.
One more time.
They didn't take kindly to it. Their attention turns to my granddaughter, for she is the last of my line, and the last hope for humanity.
Okay, so, fair warning, I haven't played this in probably close to 13, 14. Hey, you're not supposed to get back up. Run! Help me! True. Well, I think she's supposed to be hot. It's kind of hard to tell. She's pretty blocky.
Hello?
Miss Alexandra Roivas?
Yeah, who's this?
This is Inspector LeGrasse of the Rhode Island Police. I'm sorry to disturb you, but there's been an accident with your grandfather.
I'll be on the next flight out.
I'm so excited.
Miss Roivas, I'm pleased to meet you. I trust you had a pleasant trip?
Yes, I suppose so, considering.
Yes, my condolences. This is most unpleasant. It's a shame we couldn't meet under brighter circumstances.
Yeah, me too.
Yes, it is. Can we get this over with, please?
Of course. This way.
Yeah, there's one part.
But I must warn you.
I avoided for years because the first time we saw it, it was with
a
bunch of my
there's
friends.
Not much to see.
Scared the shit out of us. So I avoided the bathroom for years.
Miss Roivas, is that your grandfather, Edward?
Yes, it's him. He's wearing our family ring. I don't understand. Why are you showing me this? Can't you check dental records or something? What is wrong with you?
I'm sorry.
I think it fucked up everyone
it's
pretty hard
job,
back in the day.
It's my job, lady. You're the only living relative, and no, we can't check dental records. There's no head. Now, none of this makes sense. There's no sign of intrusion, and there was certainly a lot of force used here.
Oh, that's horrible.
I have never seen anything like this in my 20 years on the force.
I remember that.
We have no evidence except
for
the
body. Remember that happening and freaking
and
out.
What's left doesn't say much. Ugh, we don't have a single clue.
Well, you better find out who
apparently
did this.
Apparently, there were some that I missed.
I'm not leaving Rhode Island until you do. There must be some clue in this old mansion revealing what happened. I want answers.
So do I. I wish I had some.
Sorry. 2 weeks later. Shocked by her grandfather's mysterious death and frustrated at the incompetence of the local... Alex vows to uncover the truth. She decides to search the mansion, the place where Edward conducted his research. If there was a tie to his past and possibly a tie to his murder, it would be here. The music, man. The music is what did it to you. Which is, like, I love that kind of stuff. Okay. Creepy. The last weak The last weak rays of sunlight fight the shroud of darkness. It lends an eerie feel to the last few weeks' events. As the sun sets, forgot about that. Be alone in this house with nothing but the spirits of old. Because mansions are creepy, yo. The call of the mansion beckons to Alex, drawing her back to uncover the family secrets it hides. Alex will not leave till she has learned what happened to her grandfather. Okay. Yeah, I think it says the same thing here. Yeah. Okay, if I remember correctly, we're gonna go in here first. Yeah. They're badass creepy. So this is an old game, and it still kind of gives me creeps. But I'm also a weenie, so I don't think that really says too much. Illustration features a line designs related to each other in a cyclical manner. There appears to be some significance to it, but it isn't particularly. What's his name? Vash? Vash gave you money to play Nun Massacre. Y'all have to play Nun Massacre, you know. Beautiful carriage clock, hands appear to be stuck, yet the clock continues to tick, with the time permanently set to 3:33. There is a key in the back of the clock, presumably for winding it. Should Alex look at the key? Yeah. Alex picks up the desk clock and pulls the key from it. However, there is something odd about the key. It isn't for winding it at all. It looks like a dresser key. But also, don't forget to grab, Epic Games has... Epic Games has one that I've been wanting to play. Canarium? It's Lovecraft. Okay, so I've got this all backwards. Oh, don't tell me that. I'm actually kind of excited to play that game. Anything Lovecraft. Thanks to this game. Oops. This living grandfather clock seems to stand ominously in the corner, gazing on this empty room with an almost patriarchal air. Alex adjusts the clock hands? Yes! Yes. Oh. I've never pieced that together with Bloodborne. Though I didn't play it long enough to do anything either. Just punch the books, that's cool. You know, I would love to see an HD of this game. Should we look at the glowing book? It's small shrine of candles. Their placement appears to be very deliberate, matching the etchings on the table and the walls illustrate. Candles are unlit.
Yes.
Can't talk. Can I grab this? Ancient Roman weapon, a gladius. Gladius is on display above the fireplace mantle. Another token of eclectic junk. I got a sword! Okay, this bizarre drawing. Olympian City, its immense architecture bathed in a natural fog. Detail is incredible. I'm getting ahead of myself. Alex studies it. She can almost imagine the city's inhabitants. Oh, we'll meet them. Don't worry. A painting of a jungle shrouded building. It seems to be a temple in Asia, perhaps from Thailand or Cambodia. Because we had a inside joke calling it Cambodianese. Oh, funny. A diabolic drawing of a stack of human bodies, each one cemented into place. What twisted psyche could have executed this drawing? Though disturbing, it is meticulously rendered down to the precise anatomy of fractured bones and the convolutions of spines and ribs entwined into a mesmerizing sight. I'm just going to stop reading because I can't tonight. Large leather-bound antique book rests upon the cluttered desk. Should Alex read the book?
No knowledge of what was to come, nor did I care.
I've never
how the knowledge changed me. It will also change you.
We still have it.
As you read this, you will come to learn fear as I have.
Maybe not.
You too will come to understand, or you will perish. To think that once I could not see beyond the veil of our reality. To see those who dwell behind.
I can't handle being
my
chased.
My life now has purpose, for I have learned the frailty of flesh and bone.
I tried playing the first one, and I couldn't. Oh, fine. Where I think I've got Candelast? The first one.
Where is Conservandi?
Facusatis aquae sumant. Et animus eorum conferna. Hubna huis. Dia sit modo prima multarum, si ingeptum conficiamus.
Quam primum, Centurio Augustus.
Volo res
I would like to compliment you once more on your battle tactics. Our enemies did not have a chance. Do you believe that it really exists, Centurion?
I do not doubt our Emperor's beliefs.
First is
or
the
his orders.
I think that's going to be one that
I would be
better
strong,
watching than playing.
And patient.
I had trouble even watching it. But that was also before I really started playing scary games. Who knows? We might try it next month. Or after this. So I've decided to, I'm gonna play this through. Aw, I've got two PS3s. So I decided to do spooky games early. Instead of waiting until October, we're starting them now and going until the end of October. So from here till November, scary games. I'm excited. The dais on the floor is finely crafted, inlaid with golden gems that Pius can identify. Strong linear design is situated in the middle and is equally unknown to the Roman soldier. Ah, stop it. Oh, hi. I forgot there's no camera control. Ladder leads into the dank heart of the labyrinth. Danger lurks beneath, yet Pius's courageous resolve does not buckle. Should Pius climb the ladder down? I know I said that backwards, but oh well. Yay! My favorites. Clunky third-person controls with no camera control. Oh, I forgot about you guys. No. No. Get out of here. Hey. Oh yeah, I forgot. You gotta finish them. I like how they pat for their head. They're like, wait a minute. We always thought that was so cool as kids. We're like, man, look at that kill. All that gore. I'm standing in it. The strange granite block lies on the floor, inside my foot. Chaturga. Remember the other two. For some reason, I like to go with Chaturga. Easier for me for some reason. Out of here, Dell support. Lovecraftian stuff is in Bloodborne. Oh, no, wait, wait. That's Mantarok. I know that one. Oops. Ugh, fine. Ugh. Yes, we know how a health meter works. Cool. are Mandarak. He's so misunderstood. As well as prominently decorated with a strange line symbol carved with granite. Okay. Oh, It's purple. Okay, that's the fire. Yeah, I didn't make it far enough. I stopped at, what did I say, the preacher? The priest? Or did I? I don't remember. No, I got farther. Yes. Yeah, I can't. If I got past that point or not. So remember, he killed me over and over and over and over and over again. And I rage quit for a minute. Oi, hiya. He's a chump. Well, I'm also really bad at that too. I don't play like that. I don't play strategically. I like to play games on easy. Button attached to a small pylon softly illuminates the room. A bizarre energy seems to radiate from it. Should Pius push the button? Lock me in here, but okay. All right. Because I love you guys, y'all get to choose which one. Strange sculpture resembling a red-clawed worm mysteriously floats above the pedestal. So you got the red worm. Delicate dome, a pale blue statuette floats gracefully above the pedestal. You got the dome. Or an effigy resembling a warped angel shaped from dark green emerald hovers effortlessly above the pedestal. Or do you want the angel? Yeah, I like the stuff that comes along with the worm, but the angel has got some cool stuff too, but worm it is. Yes. Yeah. Turga. I'm pretty sure that's his name. Back in 2002, that was some scary shit.
Eons have passed since then, and I have learned much. Chaturga's power filled me, invigorating my dead body. With a touch, I could level buildings, rend the ground asunder, and channel power such as mortal men could only dream. Face me, and you shall surely perish.
I acquired the Tome of Eternal Darkness. Strangely, with the Tome of Eternal Darkness in her possession, Alex can read the page from the tome itself. Should Alex take the chapter page? The Binding of the Corpse God. Like the Necronomicon, yeah. Gothic cathedral is silhouetted against this stark light. The image is vicious and devoid of subtlety. Every brushstroke echoes the spikes, imbuing a violent feeling as though the building itself is a harsh imposition on reality. A grim picture. We'll be going there too. This looks like some kind of mask. The face is with a faint hint of a smile tugging at the corners of the mouth and eyes closed in deep meditation. Let's go check out the house. Oh, that's the... I heard something like scratching as the GameCube next to me. I don't think anything cool happened yet, though. Remember nothing about this room other than you can't do anything yet. Okay, go ahead and use this chapter page. Let's read it.
I cannot say what was the true beginning, nor am I sure of its end. So perhaps here is the best place to start. I am reminded of ideas I first encountered in Sir James George Frazer's book, The Golden Bough, a study in magic and religion. We are overwhelmed by a very human need to weave a web of meaning where there may be none. Since time immemorial, ancient peoples have dressed up their lack of knowledge as gods and demons. I have discovered that sometimes the fates of gods and mortals intertwine, and legends are born.
Cambodia.
Thy time is done, great ancient. Forever in shadow will you be master of chaos, and to fade to nothing in obscurity will be thy fate. My master has planned many millennia for this day. It is the true chaos of all things that you now must be entombed amongst the beings of flesh and bone.
You have a great monument here, Manturok.
Manturok.
It is a pity that no one will ever recognize it as yours. May the darkness claim thee, crawling chaos and damned beast. No longer will thy reign be kept over the ancients you have kept imprisoned.
Alrighty. Clip the good stuff, I'll try.
The last of this world.
See you on Monday.
Can keep me amused. There has to be something to do around here. I only wish something that fantastic and of higher purpose could happen to me.
You stupid. Now look at you with your wishing. I've already gotten just... It's coming back to me. Engraved in the floor is a striking design featuring the sun rising above the edge of the world. Ah, stop it. Design of the wall, okay. Yeah. Good job. Oops. And located by creatures, a sanity loss occurs, causing a decrease in the level of sanity meter and the character to pull screen. Beware, sanity loss affects perception and eventually health. That's when shit gets good. Ugh. Let me hit the dude. Basically, you see something scary, you go crazy. You lose sanity. You lose sanity, bad shit starts to happen. The design on the wall appears to depict a time of the day. Perhaps the candles do too. Okay. He's in the dock now. Forgot about that. Whoops, I'm just stepping all over. Oh, don't mind me. Can't do anything with that yet. Statue of a goddess, delicately sculpted from sandstone. It casts an alert eye over everyone who enters the temple. There is a strange necklace about its neck. Should Elia take the necklace from the statue? Yeah. Okay, so... He's not technically supposed to take that yet, but I did anyway. Oh, I wonder what's going to happen. And doop. It's quiet. Too quiet. Oh, God. I didn't think I... Oh, there I go, scaring myself. Bronze necklace sits atop an ancient clay urn. So, how could no one figure this out until just now? How has no one done this all before? Just saying. I think that's where I came from, yeah? Maybe not. Ouch. I was always really bad at that part, and I don't understand why. No, not yet. We're not taking that yet. Ow. Ah, damn it. I gotta go all the way back around. Okay. So I wanna say, ouch. How are ya? We're playing an awesome game. I've already scared myself. I know I'm supposed to go that way. Good to hear. Okay. I'm not gonna. It is the best scary game. And if you don't agree, you're wrong. Oh, God. Hey, get out of here. Yep, y'all can just stand there. That's cool. Ow. That was a gross slurping noise that they make. Okay. Alright. Oh, there we go. The bronze necklace. Is that all it did? I thought it... I think I got my timeline mixed up. Like I said, it's been a long time. So this one. No. Why is that already going? I think I know why. I don't know why I have such a hard time. I guess because there's multiple ones going. Ow. A small pedestal covered with decorative etchings stands before the wall. The blowgun upon it must have some special significance for it to be on the focal point of this display. Should Elia take the blowgun? Yeah, sure. Ah! You done boo-booed.
A secret passage in the temple.
Oh my God. All right, let's go. Hey, quit fighting. Oh. Like I said, it's been a long time. Ah, better, dude. The guard is grateful for Elia saving his life. In return, he offers his services. If Elia brings him a weapon that has been broken, he will repair it as a gesture of thanks. Not like running out of here or finding me a way out. Fix the sword for you. Do you want to repair Ilya's short sword? I guess. Thanks, Mantarok servant. Okay, I see that one. Yes, Mantarok is the best. I wish you could side with him from the get-go. Come here. Blech! I feel like there's more? I guess not. Okay. I'll come back. It's really hard to see. Who's gonna win? Red versus blue. They can fight each other, that's cool. I got winner. Can't do anything now. Yeah, I kind of forgot the blue ones explode. Even though this is an older game and I've played this one so many times, this still creeps me out. Hi, Mandy. You know, for like this whole secret organization trying to hide Mantarok, they didn't do a very good job.
Stop. Don't go near it.
So, you are reduced to feeding on flesh and bone. How the mighty have fallen. You will surely fester for millennia to come. A slow and torturous fate for thee. You had best leave, young fool.
I'm trying.
Or you'll find yourself as food for the dead god.
Nah, he likes me.
Is this? You hold one of Mantarok's hearts, the essence of a corpse god. The summit
I do too. I mean, this is just one of the
From
best games.
People, you must defend it, lest they use it to destroy what little brightness your world has left in it. Guard it well.
Mandy. metal staff is held by the arms of the statue. I got a metal staff. I'll be back later. Yeah. I mean, this is just a great game. Hey. Oh. You know, I don't need to. Oh, this is when it starts getting fun. Oh yeah. I think everyone was. Ow. That works. We always were gotten by the spiders. Oi! Hiya! Okay, my sanity is way low. Go! I forgot they grow back heads. It's still a little tense, even though it's an older game. It's still like, it gives me a lot of fun anxiety. And yeah, it's a little tense. Yeah, that I'm just it's harking back to the days when we played this a lot. Oh. No, it was not the right way. The guard resumes his duty, seemingly no worse for wear for his recent brush with death. Have I played this at night before? Oh, yeah. I can't tell you how many times I've played this through. Mess with y'all. Y'all are fine. it's Roth. The statue of a human female bears witness to the monstrosity that fills the room. The porous stone of its body is covered with the effluvial grime that Manorok has secreted over the years. Oops.
Should have run. Instead, you will die. Where is the essence of Mantarok?
I ate it. That's what you get for wishing.
Where is it? I will not ask again, child. Very well, then. You will succumb to the horrors of oblivion.
And dead. The end. I like how nothing is really happy in this game. Shrine, okay, yeah. What? Those were fake books? That's crazy. But the candles being lit, a hidden panel opens. There is a message tube inside. Alex found a message tube. An antique leather-bound message tube, the kind used to transport sealed messages. It appears to be unopened. There might be something inside. Should Alex open it? Alex has found a chapter page entitled Suspicions of Conspiracy. This one's actually my favorite.
Your presence is long missed, my liege. I feel that my power is weakening. From your absence.
Yes, your power flows from me. Without me, you are nothing.
Yeah.
My meditations reveal a flaw in
Chiturga
our plan.
Chiturga is always my first choice.
Mantarok and the others move too slowly to counter our preparations.
I think he's everybody's
Once
first choice.
Mantarok is bound, its death will be prolonged for a thousand years. Its fate will assure that the balance of power over the opposing ancients will remain in our favor. And with the Keeper nullified, my power grows stronger still.
And what of its essence?
Mantarok has employed others to defend it. It is of no matter, for the power I will wield upon my return will crush all that opposes you. Enough of this. What of this Charlemagne the Frank? Is he still a concern?
His undoing has been planned in intricate detail. Those most loyal to him will be instrumental in his death. Nothing short of a miracle will keep him alive. And there hasn't been one of those for a long time.
No miracles. After the chapter page is removed, the message tube is no longer needed. Alex discards it. Let's go look around the house now. Now I get the music going. Okay, so her sanity is a little low. Oh, you you're gonna miss some good stuff. Get coffee. It's 11:30. Okay. Because I think it's at this point you start seeing stuff. I could be wrong. Stands here, awaiting the hands of a decent musician. Unfortunately, Edward never really lived up to that description, and as such, the okay. Maybe not. Oh, we gotta go get. We can go upstairs. And okay, I guess not. All right, go get your coffee. Can't do anything yet. Well, we'll go ahead and. Oh, wait. Professor. Oh, never mind. Stop hitting the B button. The key comes apart in the lock. The key to the suction. Perhaps there's a way of repairing it. I forgot about that. Alright. We'll read this chapter.
From my research, it is apparent that the endeavors of mankind are mere puppetry at the hands of the ancients. Whenever a king vows reform, the ancients move quickly to stifle it. Under the auspices of Emperor Charlemagne the Frank, the new Holy Roman Empire was at the height of its power.
Tonc mit ad dominum et imperatorum nostrum, carolum magnum francum.
Deliver this to our Lord and Emperor Charlemagne the Frank. No one but him must see it. There are words for his eyes only. At once.
Fuck that. I'm gonna read it myself.
What sorcery is this? A spell? I am bewitched. If this was meant for Charlemagne, then what will become of him? I have to warn him of this treachery.
I remember the first handful of chapters. I remember this one's my favorite. And then Kaleem is the next one. And then after that, I don't remember. Howdy. After Anthony briefly describes his mission, the monk informs him that Charlemagne was last seen in the audience with the bishop in the visiting chamber. Go ahead and tell him that, hey, I've got a secret thing to show Charlemagne. Anthony's presence is questioned by the monks, feeling that he has trespassed upon sacred ground. The monk seems rather subdued, perhaps out of respect, or perhaps out of fear. Excuse you. Visibly disturbed with grief and despair, the monk sobs pitifully. He recounts that this is not the only death to have occurred recently, and wonders if perhaps the order is being punished for a wavering in faith. Okay. I'll be here talking to monks. Monk cordially greets Anthony. However, he brings grave news of the losses of one of his order who fell from the tower to his death. His tone is guarded, leaving Anthony wondering if, indeed, this is the truth. Monk informs Anthony that the order is awaiting the arrival of the bishop so that the funeral rites may begin. There's much grieving to do since this is not the only recent death among the order. here, buddy. You scared me. I didn't want to go up here yet. Screaming faces. Cradle on what appears to be a leathery hand lies a mysterious book. It is bound in human skin and intricately decorated with shrunken bones. It beckons and yearns to be possessed. Should Anthony claim the tome of eternal darkness? I guess I had to do that anyway. Normal up here. Blue and Urn rest upon the shelf. Now he will be ugly. Yep. Somewhat addled by Anthony's distraction, the monk kindly requests to be left alone. He said, piss off. The monk is hard at work and does not wish to be disturbed. Fine, fine. All right, let's go open this casket. Did you hear that? Oh, it's talking. Okay, I thought it was like growling. Okay. Let's kick this open. The funeral casket made from unfinished wood. It is not properly sealed and could probably be opened. Should Anthony open the casket? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I scare myself in this game. I remember too much.
Oh, my God. What
Lord,
is it?
What happened?
This is devil's work. We should get out of here.
You have proven what we have feared the most.
Dead
this
body?
This poor man has been the victim of great evil. Look how his body has been defiled, as if something has burst out from inside him. Here, take this for your protection, and find the bishop. He must be informed of this horrible discovery.
Scrimisax. Peering inside the casket, Anthony sees the body of a monk. His raiment is that of his order, stained with blood that has seeped from many grievous wounds. It is truly a disturbing sight. Yeah, that messed me up as a kid. This whole game messed me up as a kid. Okay. Kind of gross looking. A mysterious gold medallion rests upon the desk. Pick that shit up. Anthony has acquired a circle of power. Oh yeah. Circle of power describes the amount of power that a spell will have. The more points within that circle, the stronger the spell will be. Spells are magical incantations that enhance a character's natural abilities. Okay. Okay. We'll get to all that later. Amongst the tomes and manuscripts, a book brings attention to itself. Oddly pristine on the dusty shelf, it doesn't quite belong. Should Anthony move the book? I hope y'all enjoy that, boys, because I'm going to say that in that style every time. Every time. Did you eat something? Did you eat something bad? Oh. I need to equip that. What? Hurry up. Runes are the key element in creating spells. Runes. Okay. Yeah, get up. Stay down. Dusty. I'll save you. My health doesn't matter. Oh, he's just gonna stand there. Nope. What was that? This area is dark and it is difficult to make out any detail. Perhaps if Anthony had a light source. Like this thing? Grateful for his life, the monk tells Anthony what happened. He was carrying a sacred urn from the baptismal font. When he was confronted by the bishop, who was brandishing a large blade, and whose eyes burned with an evil fire, frightened, the monk dropped the urn out of shock and ran. Returning to retrieve the urn, he found only the sword the bishop had left behind. But thanks, he gives the bishop's sword to Anthony. God, I kind of can't talk. Thank you for the sword. Go look it over here. There's one. Okay, yes. There's one. Should be it. Oops. 2/3. Broken green urn. Yay. I think I can get away with just burning them. Carved stone tablet lies on the stone floor. It's a magical codex. Runes cannot be understood without a codex. Without a codex, runes in your possession will remain a mystery. I don't know what that one is. That was quick. Yeah. And dead. Ugh. I let them duke it out. Oi! Hi! I didn't see you there. Okay. Torch does not work on this guy. He does not. Come on. Red urn sits beside the fountain. I have a filled red urn. Good job, Anthony. Fumbling around, the urn slips from Anthony's stiff fingers, dashing itself into fragments as it hits the floor. This game was really advanced for its time. Okay, so can I do anything yet? Oops. Zelototh. That's it. Oh no. Oh no, I've been doing that this whole time. I love this game. Okay, yes. Oh, I can. I don't remember how to do that. I forgot you could do that. Enter my animal cellotone. Let's see. Use. Ooh, sorry. Dunk in the urn into the foul-smelling cup. It becomes filled to brim with rank fluid. It is a lot heavier now and rife with feeder. Gross water, my favorite. Catch me. Religious texts of an unspeakable nature, written in languages utterable only by monsters and corrupt humans. Plate in the floor is carved with three curious circles. Dried splashes have marked hot part and worn surface. I wonder what you do. Although the urn appears to sit correctly in place on the pressure plate, it does not appear to be heavy enough to press it. Good thing I got three of these. Amongst the books on the table rests an ancient scroll of what appears to be paper. I don't know. I don't actually know what it said. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. I don't wanna. Torn scroll illustrated with a geometric symbol is accompanied by a small that reads, "That which is broken shall be fixed. That which is dull will be sharp. This is the nature of the enchant item magic. It requires Anterbach and Magramore runes." Okay, yes, yes, yes. Okay. Yes,
to return my book. Very well, then. For your efforts, I promise.
You're looking a little rough there,
and
sir.
Merciful death.
And I'm not gonna finish them off because it doesn't matter. And it's more fun. Anthony, kinda weenie. A shrine to a god that speaks of an ancient evil that graced the earth before mankind walks its valleys. I require the bishop's key. Some yummy noises there. You are gross. Get out of here. Yeah. But with this guy, it doesn't really matter. Chopper dimension sprawls in every direction. Whilst in this place, magic cannot be cast, and humans are subjected to odd phenomena. Portals cycle from color to color as time progresses, and only the quick will escape. Yeah, I remember in Kaleem's chapter, it's very helpful. But for this one, you don't need it. Trappers have no eyes but can sense sound very well. If Anthony can sneak past them, they won't be troubled. What the heck is this? This is not how it's supposed to be. Yeah. other characters, yeah, definitely. What you gotta say to me? Monk ambles around nervously, as if to half expecting the demonic bishop to return at any moment. Or, you know, a zombie Anthony he's okay with. Hi, friend. Don't worry about the giant monster killing me. Got it. Cut off one of your faces. Yeah, we're gonna leave him there. Oh my god.
This isn't really happening.
I don't know if I've seen that one. Oh. Back. Oh. Can I leave? Anthony cannot leave yet. Charlemagne must be warned of the conspiracy against him. And I love that. I mean, I've played this game at least 4 or 5 times. Okay. And I love that some of this is still new. Muffled voices emanate from inside the bishop's visiting chamber. However, the door is locked and Anthony will need the bishop's key. Okay, yeah.
Trying to save him, Anthony. His fate was decided many centuries ago, as is the fate of this world.
Poor Anthony.
Despite your faith, there is little to save you from the power of Chaturna.
I love those. And by love, I mean I really hate those. Kinda got me, I won't lie. That kinda got me. mean, it's taking me back to my, like, when I was, like, 11, 12, whatever. Let's see, this is 2002. So, yeah, I was 12, 12, 13. Gonna answer the door. That's a bloody painting. Yeah, that creeped me out back in the day. Is there any painting of Mountain Valley delicately rendered in oils? Time has taken its toll on the surface, which is soiled with dirt and scratches. Eyes up here, buddy. So we were talking about this earlier. In this room here, really messed me up as a kid. Remember the first time we saw that? It was me and a bunch of my friends and my mom. Lights like pitch black playing this on our big TV, and we did that and everybody shrieked. It was years before I looked at that again. Oh my god, it got me so bad back in the day. Like I would, like, when I came in the bathroom, I would like come like way over here to get it. That's right, you do, Capybara. Everybody likes this game. You like it or you're wrong. This is one of the best games. So weird. One of the drawers in the dresser, curiously, has no keyhole. In its place is a small triangular design flanked by a magical symbol. You love being wrong? No, you're not wrong. You like this game. Why would you have that in your bedroom? Just... Alex questions the presence of a these morbid pieces. Could it be a single ray of hope encircled by the encroaching darkness? Nah. Thank you for the ammunition, Grandpa. As Maximilian Roivus is the next one. Is that? Oh no, that's the journal. I'm sorry. This is a page from Maximilian Roivus' journal. It reads, "Everything that brightened my life now engulfed me in darkness. I fed on the light of truth, yet starved on the shadows. I have learned through my lifetime, but no less than a newborn baby." Oh, wait. I have a key. I forget that you can't just use stuff from the dialogue. You have to actually use it. Okay. It's over here then. Alex searches the drawer for some means of unlocking it, but can find none. However, the key is definitely a dresser key. Chapter page has been hastily stashed behind the frame of the painting. Should Alex retrieve the chapter page? I almost forgot. The gift of forever. Wait, what did it say? an oddly proportioned painting of a man in shotgun garb. Obviously an intentional exaggeration, it gives the painting an oddly quirky feel. All you need is a hairy man, baby, and then you're all set. Werewolf baby man. Is it this one? Okay. Is it this? Okay. I don't remember where it goes. It's around here somewhere though. There was a drawer, but it had a way for a key. I don't have the right enchantment for it. It's too dark in here to do anything. Perhaps the circuit has been broken. Yeah, I think it's much, much later. Because I tried to enchant the key and it wouldn't let me. Sorry. Okay, I think that's everything I can do right now. I don't want to do this one. I don't either. It's been, like I said, since I was like 12, 13, probably about 15, so. Alright, actually first let's save. We're gonna start a new game. Yes. Yeah. I guess my other save didn't with another card. Oh well. I had one where I played at least twice, so I had Chaturga and Mantarok. What are you even thinking about? Like that. Let me tap my chin. Oh, I've played it. Completed, I've probably done it 4 times. I've played this through a good handful of times. Alright, let's do... I don't enjoy this one. After Anthony's, they're not as fun.
Dreams. Modern psychology offers only unproven theories. Some see them as the meaningless tossing and turning of a brain settling into a restful sleep. Others see them as laden with symbols of our unconscious desires. To still others, dreams represent the upwelling of the archetypes, normally hidden deep within the recesses of the human collective unconscious.
All right.
Of one thing I am certain. After a brush with the ancients, our dreams metamorphosize into nightmares.
I have implored you for years, yet you ignore all my advances. You dominate my dreams. Think of nothing else. I fear I desire you many hundred times more than you love me.
My life has become a waking dream, Kareem. For weeks, I have dreamed of an ancient treasure so precious that it changes all life around it. It must be mine, Kareem.
Demanding much?
If you truly desire me, as you say, then you will find this for me. Bring this treasure to me, and I will be yours. both of our dreams will come true.
I need nothing more than you. You have enthralled me to the point where I can think of nothing else. Promise, if I leave, you will not forget about me.
You need not worry. I desire nothing more than the treasure that you seek. Leave now, Kareem, and I shall await you.
No, she won't. He's like, yeah, sure. If you say so. A man's corpse lies fallen. Wounds cover the exposed flesh of his body where his armor has failed. Sorry. It's a very, bubbly beer. Ilya. Augustus. Eat it, make it. I do too. Squish. Squish the faces. Anthony. Should Kareem claim the Torn of Eternal Darkness? Yes. They woke up. Guys just standing there. Hey. The quicker I can get through this one, the better. Couple. Yeah. Is my audio delayed? Let's see. Seems like it. Hold on. I might be able to fix this. Give me a second. One second. Sometimes resetting a little bit better. There we go. I don't know why it lags sometimes, but it does. It felt like a kung fu movie. Hey, you big guy. Okay, you're just gonna stay there. Statuette vaguely resembling a man stands atop a loop. I guess that's a man. very vague. Okay, up we go. Arcane shrine dominates the room for Zeres. Surrounded by edge, while a larger one tops the summit. I doubt each one would be filled with incense to facilitate prayer to insidious deity. Am I missing one? Oh. I forgot. You gotta do the three statues to get down there, not past here. A torch hangs upon the wall. I got a torch. Whoops. How am I looking? I don't feel like I need a talisman yet. Not yet. Oops. And guess who's on there? These guys! Has risen from the floor, exposing what appears to be a lifting mechanism. Should Kareem use the device to descend? Yeah. He is. Like I said, the faster through this one, the better. Okay. In a pool of cold blood is a dead soldier. He is the victim of an unseen battle. Perhaps this man died from the claws of the monsters of this place. It is difficult to tell. Oh, I forgot. Alright, let me try that again. The man lies dead, anointed in blood from ravages of a Tolwar sword. The wounds, deep and numerous, seek fresh blood, precise yet powerful. The result of a man's actions, not a monster's. Should Kareem retrieve? That's how you know I'm getting tired. Okay, and we're going to enchant this.
Enter my Celadon.
Alive. Turn around. Come on.
Ah!
Okay. He's on the other side, right? Either way, go ahead. Yeah, because that's not very much. Dead man. Who are these men whose corpses littered the dungeon? And where are you soldiers who stumbled inside? Grave robbers looking to plunder it. Crumpled scroll lies under the dead man's curled fingers. Recover! Okay, can I do that one yet? Check. Narakoth and Santak. Gotta be crazy for a minute, I guess. Oh my god, you suck. Oh my. Stop. Uncrazy. Oh my god. Okay. That was very aggravating. I'm gonna use a talisman. I didn't move. I do, but it's not really doing anything for me. Especially when I'm surrounded like that, it doesn't seem to do much for me. Come on. The only thing is, with the talisman, you have to be perfectly still, otherwise it'll kill you. Ugh. Kareem has perished at the hands of eternal darkness. With no one to stop the diabolical plans, humanity will surely be annihilated. And let me guess, it's going to start back from where I just was? Yeah. So that one you have to save, like, this game you have to save pretty spot on. This one is Kareem. The darkness comes. So, like, all that stuff I just did. Yeah. kind of mad now. No, just mad that this is an older game with older rules, and there's no autosave. This bad off this early in the level. Come on. So this save file is from way back in the day. Can't do a little bit better this time.
My dear Alex, I will always be at your side. There are times when insanity takes hold and nothing seems right. During those times, I will help you. Fear not, for I will keep the darkness away.
I guess I was just more insane this time.
This isn't really happening.
More insane. I think I'm gonna have one take me. Maybe not. Okay. That's okay then. Oi. Hi. Didn't see you there. Get one. That's okay. Ah, there's a guy over there too. We'll save over this one. I just sliced him in half. Not even cool.
This isn't really happening.
That got me for a split second. That got me for quite a split second. Yeah, that one takes a lot of sanity. They are. Uh-oh. No, 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 no. Thank you. Now, why was it so much easier this time than it was last time? Whatever. All right. Yeah. Just. Ugh. Got it. Please. Alright. First, no, we're going to do this. Okay, yes, we saw that last time. Okay, Narakath and Santak. We're gonna get a little bit less crazier. Thank God. I'm just glad I had that other save slot. I would have been very upset if I had to do all that over again. Uh-oh. Large Remdal broadsword protrudes from a solid pedestal made of stone and awaits its next owner. Should Kareem try and pull the sword from the stone? Oh, come on now. Can I hit you, please? Please. Isn't that Chiturgus? Symbol? Oh boy. Oh. Okay. Is that all, please? Okay. Sure it is. Yes. Finally. This is when the game gets a lot nicer. Oh yeah. We got Chiturga and Zelotoph and nobody. How's everything else looking? Okay, I need to save. Ceiling has collapsed, creating an impassable pile of rubble. Okay, it's just the one. You know what? We're gonna heal up a little bit more. Okay, now, since we're here, we're gonna save. Yeah, we're gonna spam save. So this, I need to... Metallic plate replaces the lock, a color sigil is engraved in metal above the white slot. The slot appears to be wide enough to insert a large blade. Oh, fine. Sleep. Again, spam save. Oops. Cause I don't trust it. I don't trust my memory of this one. Damn it. I didn't see him there until I was like right on top of it. Let's see, what do I need? My magic's healed, so I don't really need anything. Damn. That was a bit harsh. I've never heard that one either. Yeah. I think it was a glitch. Like a sound glitch. Ruby effigy stands upon this pedestal centered in the room. Just because I don't remember how any of this goes. Yeah, I thought so too. Oh. I was like, wait a minute, where am I? They're all gonna be up there still, aren't they? That doesn't tell me anything. I wish they'd just stop shaking their butts around and do something. I'm not going the right way, am I, guys? Yeah, I've never, in any of my playthroughs, used those. Never used those. Okay, so yeah, that was not the right way. Just go ahead and go get some sanity. No! You know what? Fine. We'll play it your way. That's right. You can't cast any spells. And I'm getting annoyed. And why is my computer trying to do something? No, we're not installing updates right now. We can wait. here for some reason? After this chapter. I will finish this chapter. Oh, the walls are dripping blood. Wasn't anything over here. Okay. Wait, what was that? Along the length of the corridor, the ceiling has given way. Blech. Okay. Should Kareem climb over the rubble? Blasphemous sculpture made from human skin and bone, a trestle of bone is cradled within a shrine, like a nightmarish bookstand beckoning to be used. I don't remember any of this part at all. Sorry, spam save. Okay. Am I not in the right spot? Okay. You can have that. I guess not. I feel like we're almost there. Oops. Oh, God. No. Thanks. But I spam saved. I know it's coming now, so just make sure to heal up. Ooh. I'm okay. And I've still got this much of a beer left. Good to go now. Okay. Oh no. I think that's the end, but I'm not gonna chance it. An effigy resembling a warped angel, shaped from dark green emerald, hovers effortlessly above the pedestal. Should Kareem claim this artifact? Yes.
Kareem.
Better safe than sorry. Oh yeah.
Forever.
Chandra?
I'm dead.
To you.
Things change, my dear Kareem. But even though my body is ravaged, I await you.
Who did this to you?
You were gone so long.
A whole day.
I gave myself to a nobleman with a jealous mistress. She had me dragged from my bed, and in cruel revenge, flensed with knives. As the last blades were drawn across my body, and my blood cooled upon the floor. She cursed that I would only be with another in death.
So much for thinking only of me. I should never have left.
I have seen my folly and have already paid dearly. I see so much more now. In death, I know the true value of the artifact which I asked you to find. And it is not for us to possess. If we are to be together again, you must make a sacrifice. Only when that is complete will we be together.
Sacrifice?
Sounds a little much.
Why should I do anything for you? You lied to me. Betrayed me. You really don't look so good anymore.
You must forget the past. Despite who you are now, you will also become something more. Just as I am. But the sacrifice must be made. We must remain here and guard the artifact.
Also, welcome in, comics.
Dark things will come to claim it, and you must be strong to keep it from them. Without your sacrifice, the world will fall into eternal darkness.
The things I do for love.
Hey. Nice. Welcome in, Elfesh. Only took 2 hours. That was a long one. Alright. So we'll save here. We'll go find all the cool stuff. We'll find the next chapter and then we'll call it good. No. I'll let you decide that when I come across weird stuff. Oops. Why is my sword enchanted?
Hello?
Remember me, Alex.
Get rid of Vega trapped in the past. I think so. I think this is one. Grandpa goes to extreme lengths to keep his pantry shut. Hey, rat! It's a rat friend! Among the pantry contents is a space drawer with a scrap of paper hidden inside. Alex has found a spice jar. Okay. Really? Oh, this is a great one. Firmly sealed glass spice jar. The faint aroma of Arabian spices is tantalizing and emanating from it. Or is it? Should Alex open the jar? The lurking horror. That's... Oh, you missed that.
In the age of darkness has been extinguished.
As did I.
The pillar of flesh has been constructed. The master of chaos, the keeper of the ancients, is long dead. The planets will be in alignment soon. All is prepared for your arrival. I will begin the final incantation that will bring you into our world within days. The next millennium will truly usher in a new age. Your guardians, now prepare the gate.
Okay. What's the next chapter again? See ya. Yeah, I mean, even for an older game, it still looks fantastic. I guess he's just gonna run around. So green is strong against blue, blue is strong against red. Okay. I don't think there was anything else. This is fine. Normal. Nothing going on. And I don't think there's anything else to really look at right now. Oh, another bleeding painting. She's like, God, this is disgusting. Portraits of the ancestral Roivas line the foyer walls. Their faces reveal a dark, brooding edge. There is something about each one that gives the viewer an unsettling feeling. Alrighty. Alright, well sadly, I have to end it here. It is bedtime. But I will be back tomorrow to continue. And the day after that, and the day after that, we will finish this one. I'm going to go ahead and reset this so I don't have to listen to that over and over and over again. But thank you all so much for hanging out tonight. If you haven't done so already, feel free to hit that follow button. That way you can see when I'm on tomorrow. Why isn't it not doing anything? Anyway, all right, well, thank you all so much for hanging out, and I will see y'all later.